What's he doing? No, no, no.
It's an heavy one, Captain.
Oh, there's the deal. It's
a war chest, I imagine, filled with Spanish doubloons.
What the hell is it?
It's the Holy Grail.
Don't be ridiculous, me idiota. There's no such thing.
What? It's Aladdin's lamp, then.
There's something inside it.
What's the matter?
It's possessed. The damn thing's got a ghost inside it.
Or a genie. Maybe it'll grant us a wish or two.
It's not of this world.
You're an artist.
What now?
What's up, twins?
Slidy's gone and got himself nicked.
Any instructions from Peter?
No, he's gone quiet.
Must be about Roberti.
We don't have no plans for Babe or Bertie, do we?
Wait, look over there.
Excuse me, officer, you dropped this.
What? Impossible. Must have a buckle loose.
And you dropped this.
It's my whistle. Well, how did
you... It was down there, with your keys.
My keys!
You've got the blood!
Watch his eyes. Remember, a man's intent is in his eyes.
Sometimes smaller is smarter.
Jimmy's gonna love this. Well done, Peter.
I've got a nice job for you boys.
How nice?
Harbottle's Antiques.
Are you mad?
You're ready.
That place is tighter than a towel.
We'll get nicked for sure. Sorry, Jimmy. Too dangerous.
I think it's a brilliant idea. Harbottle's has two doors, as I remember. One at the front and one at the back leading to an alley. There is a night guard, of course, and the windows are sealed shut. But there are other ways in if you're small and cunning.
If we get nicked, it won't be the orphanage they throw us in. It'll be the clink. We wouldn't last a week.
Weren't you at the bottom of Hackney Canal when Jimmy found you? Tied in a sack with stones around your wrists and ankles. Jimmy's rescued every one of you. He's pulled you from the workhouses and asylums. He's given you a home. Food in your belly and shoes in your feet. Isn't it time we paid him back? Harbottle's Antiques. All who's with me, raise your right hand.
Words in your ear, Peter. Carly's right. This one's too dangerous.
But it's worth it.
How do you know?
You wouldn't risk it otherwise.
You're growing up quickly, Peter, but you still have a lot to learn.
Do you want to do this job or not?
Oh, I want to do it, all right. It's what I've been waiting for. It might get me back where I belong. But I've changed my mind. I'm going it alone on this one.
You don't trust me.
I don't want you to get nicked.
I'll get us in and out safe.
No. This one's mine. Things will be different when you're older.
Chris? What do you think of accounting?
What?
Bookkeeping. I had an uncle on Pinner who made bucket loads from just adding things up.
Sounds a bit dull, Fox.
He had a good life. Married a draper's daughter from Bexley Heath. Brenda Fitzwilliam. Nice smile.
Fox, what are you talking about?
The future. Something to look forward to. What about you, Pierre? You ever think of the future?
I'm sticking with Jimmy.
If you're not careful, you'll grow up to be just like him.
And what's wrong with that?
It's a dangerous life.
Adventurous, you mean? You want to spend the rest of your days in the shoebox? Fine. But I want more. Now, Jimmy's going places and so am I. One day we'll be partners. Believe me, that day can't come soon enough. Come on, we've got a job to do.
What, job?
Yeah, Harbottle's Antiques, remember?
Tonight? Well, Jimmy didn't say anything about doing it tonight.
Jimmy doesn't have to know. We'll surprise him.
Make it look like an ordinary break-in. Take whatever else you want.
Of course.
And should you be lucky enough to find the artifact there, handle it with the utmost care.
Have you considered my terms?
Money's not a problem, but the other business is more difficult.
I'm afraid it's not negotiable.
My client is using what influence he has, but...
But what?
Re-establishing your position in London society is proving more troublesome than he thought. The Granville Club won't take you back. And most of the new businessmen he spoke to want concrete references. Introductions are no longer enough.
Well, if anyone can do it, Flood can.
As I said, he's doing his best. There's a slip up. We don't know you. Understand?
Perfect.
It's September! I get lost, ruddy pests!
See, couldn't be easier. Isn't this what you wanted?
You know it isn't. I changed my mind. I told you I was doing this one alone.
Yeah, but look. We're in. Why didn't you tell us, Peter? Because you wouldn't have done it. Oh, so you lied to us? I wanted to show Jimmy what we were made of. He thought we were too young.
I am too young.
Fill your bags and wait by the door. Carly, keep an eye up the back. Nibs, what's the front?
Sorry, Jimmy. I just wanted to show you that I could do it.
If you're going to be my partner one day, you must never go behind my back.
One day. But I'm ready now.
Believe me, you've got a lot of growing up to do first.
You looking for something in particular, Jimmy? I'll go find something to force it open.
What is it?
Wow. Not bad. It's all your fault, Peter. If you'd done as Jimmy said and just left it alone. Then they'd still be here. You were looking for this, weren't you, Jimmy? Who are you working for?
Where's Jimmy?
He's out.
When will he be back?
What do you want him for? What do you want with Jimmy? Oi, come back!
Why do you follow Jeffries, boy? Jimmy didn't send you, did he?
What do you want with Jimmy?
That's my business. Where is he?
Just gone.
What do you mean, gone?
A bomb in Hobbles.
He found the orb, didn't he?
You know what that thing is.
So it was in hard bottles after all.
Jimmy was working for you.
Where is it now? Tell me!
It blew him up and all my crew.
Let him go, Jeffries. They weren't blown up.
Where are they then?
Another world, more beautiful than you can imagine. By back if you tell me where the orb is.
How?
It's a portal. A kind of door. And the slightest knock will activate it. But we must hurry. Heavens, Jeffries, if I'd have known it was at Har Bottles for sure, I'd have engaged someone more diligently. Hey! After him! Hurry, Jeffrey!
A door to another world. Slightest knock, eh? What a weird looking place. But you're in there somewhere. Ain't you, Jimmy?
Open up, Peter. We can help you.
Help me? When has a top ever helped the likes of me? I got into this. I'm gonna get him out.
Lots of smoke. No flames. Give me that.
No!
We've landed in hell, I tell you. Soon, Lucifer's demons will rise up to record our sins and throw us down there into the everlasting fire of damnation, where we will burn in agony for all eternity.
Buongiorno, amico. Got any goodies?
Leave us alone!
Go! Let me go!
Go!
Just get off! Get off!
Found another five!
Get off of me!
It's one!
Off me!
Let me go!
Jimmy! Tootles.
Thank you.
Where did you spring from?
You have no idea how glad I am to see you.
Where the hell have we landed?
I have no idea. All I know is we're not in Shoreditch anymore.
It was that thing. In Harbottles, wasn't it?
I'm sorry, Fox. It's all my fault. We should never have broken into Harbottles in the first place.
If Curly was here, he'd string you up.
I'll make good. I'll get them off that ship and home safe.
Ship?
A pirate ship.
It's a bloody nightmare. Weird crocs, spooky woods, no pirates. What's next? Swarms of flying beasties.
What's that?
Oh, what now?
Run!
What year do you come from?
1906.
Oh, that'll make me 163 next October.
263, you mean?
Oh, maybe I start thinking about settling down. Nice cottage on Venus.
From the 1700s, how's that possible?
Cod liver oil, stewed prunes, and regular trips up the rigging. Good for you.
What are you good for?
I wonder.
It still works. Tick tock. Tick tock. Tick tock.
Tick tock. Tick tock. Tick tock. Tick tock. Did you bring anything else with you? Did you? Oh, sugared almonds, perhaps.
Just what you see.
Pity! How sweet. He carries a picture of his true love.
What is this place?
Can't you tell? It's heaven. Or hell. Depending on your point of view.
See? Lucifer's demons.
What shall we do with them,
Well, I want the English lads.
What for?
They look so tender. I bet they taste good in a stew.
My boys stay with me.
He's a bold one, no?
He's not a bad looking wag.
Eh?
Maybe I could find a use for him in my cabin.
Good idea. Maybe I need a rest, eh?
Just playing with you, Starkey. I'm just playing with you.
Throw him to the crocs.
It's me. You can keep the boys.
Oh, thank you, ma'am. You won't be sorry. I've got some coriander seeds and some ginger sage. Right. Now, you better come with me. You're not going to like this.
Jimmy.
Come on.
Come and take him.
Yeah!
stay with me.
What I was good for, well, as you can see, I'm handy with a blade.
Who are you?
My friends call me Jimmy.
Jimmy?
But the name's Hook. James Hook.
I'm sorry for this, but entrance to our village is secret.
What are you gonna do with us?
Dinner.
You're gonna eat us?
Why, do you taste good? Come, you must be hungry.
What's this meat?
Shot.
Are we in America?
Not anymore.
But you're Indians.
We are the Ka, people of the Raven. We've become part of this world now.
Do you know the way back to London?
The chief.
Goyatsehi! Goyatse! Alangatla, Atlanskata.
Jit ik ogwe.
Layandagan, Isquayang hikit, Lahilakut.
Chasing tree spirits is hungry work.
Is the Dagadan, Isquayang, Guayak.
He asks if you want to join our tribe.
Thank you, but once we finish dinner, we'll be on our way.
Got on enough.
Gajidei!
We saved you before. We may not be there to save you again.
We're very grateful. But we have to rescue our friends from pirates.
Got on enough.
Das Adam. TG.
I have Das.
Where are we?
We call this Guai Guang, Neverland.
Why?
Because we never age here. You might not believe this, but I am 130 years old. Inu's son is 81.
Kijanga!
The chief's daughter. She is called Ayakang, Tiger Lily in your language. She is named this because she is as wild as she is beautiful.
Kunasta deodon. Kai hit natsa.
Don't get any ideas because she is almost 100 years old.
Taki koya natsa.
You've left me with a bit of a problem.
Three of my best men dead. One was my personal bodyguard.
It was self-defense.
That's not the point. I can't get replacements here.
No.
You're not in London now, Hook. Do you notice anything unusual out there?
I don't follow.
Orion. Polaris. Maybe you can point to the pole star.
Astronomy is not my best suit.
Well, if it was, you'd notice that there isn't a pole star. And Orion is over there. In the wrong place.
How's that possible?
The planet Earth is in a different galaxy. Far, far away. There's no way back.
Are you sure?
I've had almost 200 years to work it out.
We've got to fatten you up and no mistake.
Any bread and jam?
I've got cream cakes, sweetmeats, pickled herring, and crystallized dates. But sadly, no bread and jam, Your Highness.
We're stuck here, but it needn't be all bad. This planet has something special to offer. It's mined by creatures of this world. The Indians call them tree spirits. This is the stuff that makes them fly.
Indians?
We're not the only ones from our world, Hook. See, a year ago I captured one of them. He was carrying this mineral, and under torture, he told me of its power. It'll make you feel more alive. More complete than you've ever felt. It'll light you up from inside. Literally, turn you into a god. And give you the power to fly. As you can see, it's unstable. But that's only because I don't know how to use it yet. Besides, I only have enough for this magic trick. We need more. Lots more. The only problem is we can't get near the tree spirits. They're protected by the Kaw Mountains on one side and the savages on the other. Join me, Hook. I badly need fresh blood, and you bring knowledge from a modern world. You help me defeat the savages. And together we can rule Neverland like gods. And turn this endless purgatory into an eternal paradise.
Gods.
Yes. Gods.
What are you doing up here, Starkey? Don't the captain need you tonight?
Leave me alone!
Oh dear.
There must be a way down.
We will build you and your friend a hut.
Thank you.
Why live up here?
To be near the tree spirits. That is their city. We protect them from the pirates.
How do you get down to the sea from here?
The same way you were brought in. Through a secret passage through those mountains.
Will you show me?
If you try to rescue your friend, the pirates will capture and torture you until you show them the mountain passage.
But I can't just sit on my hands. I'm the one that got them into this mess. I've got to find a way to get them home, safe.
There is no way home.
What? No. There is a way back. There must be. Fox! Fox, I have a plan. For what? To get us out of here and onto that ship. Come on. See what they're carrying? Fishing nets.
So?
Have you seen any fishing waters around here?
No.
Exactly.
I don't understand.
That's how we're gonna find the secret passage through the mountains. Come on.
How are we gonna get them out, Pierre? They're surrounded by pirates.
Yeah. But sleeping pirates. Drunk, sleeping pirates.
Going anywhere with you.
Shut it, Curly. He's here to help.
Yeah, he's the one who got us into this mess in the first place.
And I'm the one that's getting you out.
You want to stay? Fine. You want to live? Follow us.
Did I ever tell you my recipe for turtle soup?
Please, Smee.
Shh.
Hey. Something she is not right.
What?
I'm going to go look around.
I wouldn't do that if I was you. Not up there in Bonnie's cabin.
Thank you.
Where's Jimmy?
The captain's quarters.
You sure?
She's got a shine for him.
She?
What are you going for?
To get Jimmy.
But we're all here. We can make a clean getaway if we go now.
I'm not going without Jimmy.
Jimmy.
Peter, how did you get here?
Get your clothes on. I've got a canoe waiting below.
Put the pistol down, Peter. Bonnie's a friend.
Bonnie?
How many more in your litter, Hook?
Let me speak to him. Didn't know he was here. Give me the gun, Peter.
Wait, Jackie!
Peter, give me the gun!
Tell him to put his away first.
Listen to me, Peter. Captain Bonnie and her men are on our side. She's assured me that the boys will be well looked after.
The Indians say they're crazy.
Indians?
He's with the savages.
Trust me, Peter, they're anything but crazy. These are our people. It's a dangerous place. They can help us survive.
You want to stay here? With her?
We've nowhere else to go.
We can stay with the Indians until we find a way home.
They'll scalp and skin the lot of you.
No, they won't. They're good people.
How do you know?
They're kind.
Listen to me, Peter. I'm staying here. If you want to stick with me, give me the gun.
And trust them, Jimmy.
So trust me. Give me the gun.
Hook!
Leave it.
Your little rat! Piccolo rat!
Your boys are gone, Smee, but I captured this one.
He's not one of my boys.
Hook, he had him working behind our backs.
What did you do with my boy?
Leave him be! He's just a boy! Doesn't know what he's doing.
I'm gonna kill him if he don't tell me what he's done with my boys.
Where are the others, Peter? We must all stick together.
Not here. Not with these crazies.
You're safe with me. Now let's go inside, get something to eat, and forget this foolishness.
Quick, hurry! Come on, quick!
came back for you.
Jump! Jump! Jump now, you'll make the canoe.
Jump, Fox!
We trusted you, gave you the freedom of our village, and you abused that trust.
Stole
two canoes and used the mountain passage without our consent. I should punish you, but in light of your loss, I will be lenient this time.
Things have come a long way since I terrorized the Spanish Main. What else is new? Flying machines.
Where's this Indian settlement?
You would choose the boys over me?
I'm responsible for them. I brought them here. They look up
to me.
What
do you do when you find them?
They're clever. Trained in the streets, pickpockets, they could be useful to us. Help us find the mineral dust.
Us?
I've never met anyone like you.
And what about her? You've forgotten already.
She passed away many years ago.
But you still carry her portrait.
She had a hold on me once. Now I have you.
I'll give you what you want, Hook. But only if you give me what I want. There is no us. Understand? I let you live because I want to know what you know. All 200 years of it.
You lied to us. We never should have broken into Harbottles.
You were just showing off to Jimmy.
Now we're stuck here.
Whatever he is.
And he got Fox killed.
Clearly!
And we were all in that canoe. All right, we could have all got away, but he had to go back for Jimmy.
What's the point of rubbing it in? Curly's right. I got Fox killed.
Should go. At the end up. Not down.
You know this tune?
Come.
Where did you see this?
In here.
A dream?
The same dream every night. You had the dream too, don't you?
Uh-huh.
That music is the sound of tree spirit wings.
He's holding the orb, isn't he? That isn't quite right. The peaks were different in my dream.
Try it.
It's something like... No.
Can I try? Something like this?
Do you have the dream too?
No. But I hunt and fish. We call that Bull Mountain. We've never been there. It's too far away. But we can see it on a clear day when we pass the outer islands.
So the hooded man was in Neverland. Why do we have the same dream?
How did you get to Neverland?
I hit the orb with my dagger.
Me too, with the staff. I hit it so hard, I brought the whole tribe with me. Perhaps part of its great power enters those who strike it.
Do you think the hooded man is still there? How do I get to this island?
I'm coming with you.
No, Toots. It's too dangerous.
I don't care.
But I do. I've done enough damage. Look, it's just a dream. It will probably turn out to be a wild goose chase, but if I do find a way home, I'll be back for you and the others, okay?
What do I tell them?
To sit tight and wait for me. And that I promise I'll do everything I can to get them home safe.
We'll find the mineral dust here, in the tree spirit colony. But the problem is it's within the Kaw territory. The mountains from the north to the east are impregnable, and tall cliffs line the course. There's no way through.
How do the Indians get in and out?
We don't know. We can watch them cook on their campfires from across a narrow ravine, but if we try to rope across, they will pick us off like gulls on a gaff rig. They hunt on this part of the island, going back and forth as if these mountains weren't even there. Any ideas?
Perhaps we should watch them a little more closely.
Chief's daughter is a prize indeed. She'll tell us how to get into the tree spirit colony. I'll send some men to cut them off.
No. Sometimes smaller is smarter. They're up to something. Let's find out what first.
He was standing on a hill in front of the mountain.
There must be 100 hills here.
Let's try that one.
I have found it.
The prints go this way.
Right then. Let's go.
Your family back home must be very worried about you.
I don't have a family. My mother died when I was 3, and I never knew my father. So I was brought up in a workhouse.
Is that where you met your friends?
Nah. No, I was the only kid there. Punchbag, they called me. Jimmy fished me out. He's visiting one day and saw me getting a kicking. He was a good man once. The best. He saved my life, but that pirate turned his head.
Recognize anything?
It wasn't as overgrown in my dream. Let's find a place to rest. It'll be dark soon. She might lead us to the hooded man. See her?
No, she's too fast. I've never seen a tree spirit glow like that. She's really beautiful. Oh, no.
What?
The sun's coming up. Now we're never gonna find her. I've never seen anything like this.
Gotta find a way in. He must be in there. How are you at climbing?
It's a mile high.
Then we better get started. Anyone down there?
No.
Come on. Down is sometimes harder than up.
Where is everyone?
They'll come to us.
How do you know?
Anyone clever enough to make all this already knows we're here.
That's right.
You. You're the hooded man.
Hello, Peter.
Can you get us home?
Of course. Now that I'm here, everything shall find its proper place.
You have the orb?
In a manner of speaking. Finally, after almost 350 years, it's back where it belongs. Now we can start to bring the elite of our world here to my utopia.
So how will you get us back?
Patience, young friend.
You made all this?
Mm-hmm. It's easier than it looks. A simple growth solution which compels the forest to grow in the way that I want it to grow.
Who are you?
Oh, my apologies. My name is Dr. Richard Flood, alchemist to Her Majesty, Queen Elizabeth I.
What?
Hard to believe, I know, but I am almost 400 years old. Come, I'll show you my life's work.
It's only a few hours old.
I was engaged in the search for the Philosopher's Stone, the elixir believed to grant everlasting life.
There were others like me, of course, but they were all trying to make a tangible substance which could be consumed in some way. What I discovered was that the Philosopher's Stone cannot be made. It has to be trapped.
You see, it's a form of cosmic energy which lives at the very center of the universe. Where its four corners meet. This is the shape of the universe. Here, at its center, is this tiny planet.
Neverland.
And because it lives at the farthest reaches of the universe as well as at its center, time stands still for all those who come here.
So how do we get back?
When I first arrived on this planet, I was stuck here.
Because, of course, the orb that I'd made in London remained there. But as you know, the harder you strike the orb, the more it... So thankfully, most of the contents of my laboratory traveled with me. And in time, I was able to build a twin.
I activated it here in Neverland with the power from two meteors.
It's just like the other one.
I call her Tinkerbell because of the beautiful sound her wings make through the air. When she saw me harnessing the astral energy of two meteors, she thought I was in trouble, tried to save me.
That's my dream.
All who activate the orb are imprinted with that memory.
Why does she glow so bright?
and much of that astral energy is trapped inside her. Come. We'll take the orb below. There's an open area where I can send you both back.
No, not yet. I've got to find my friends.
Seems I have more guests.
What's it all for?
Mi sento il diavolo.
Attention. There could be demons lurking behind these walls.
No, only me.
That's the man in my dream.
Flood.
You know him.
Dr. Flood.
Danger here.
Why such a big city for just one man?
It will soon be filled with the elite of our world. Artists, statesmen, philosophers.
What the hell for?
I think what great minds can achieve if they have the rest of eternity to study.
Can you help us get back to London?
Yes.
Did you send Peter back already?
Not yet.
Then where is he?
As I said, this is a sanctuary. All who enter here are granted my protection. If you lay down your weapons, I can start to prepare your return.
I don't want to go back.
No.
Who wants to return to the Caribbean?
Do you think we'd still strike terror into men's hearts? Tell them, Hook. Tell them how it's changed. We wouldn't last a week. And if we did, we'd grow old quickly in a world that we no longer understand. Is that what you want?
No, of course not.
But we don't want legions of pompous braggarts coming here either with the fancy new weapons, telling us how to live our lives. No. Now you tell me how it's done. Is there a door? Or another sphere like the one that brought us here?
If you don't want to use it, why do you care?
Because, Dr. Flood, I want to police it.
I won't allow that to happen. I won't tolerate violence. Here. Leave now, and your lives will be spared.
Shoot them! Shoot them all!
Dealing with forces beyond your understanding.
Run! Run for your lives!
Peter! Peter, wait, I need to talk to you.
Peter! Over here!
Thank you.
flood?
Took me almost a century to grow my city. Look how quickly it disappears.
Where's Aya?
I don't know. Try and save the orb. I'll face them here. Go, 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 go! I just want to see Peter safe.
Engaging you, Hook, was a terrible mistake.
The glass sphere, Flood. Where is it?
I'd rather burn in hell.
You're responsible for this! Going back.
You can't have it.
What makes you think I want it?
I heard your girlfriend. You don't want people going back.
It doesn't mean you, Peter. I'll make sure you get back safely.
Then let me take it back to my crew.
I have a better idea. Why don't they come to us?
Us? Who's us? The pirates? Because they will kill them. Just like they kill Fox.
That was a terrible mistake. I tried to stop.
You let it happen. You become one of them.
Listen to me, Peter. There's something in this world that will completely change our lives in London, make us more powerful than you can ever imagine. And Bonnie and her men can help us find it.
She's turned your head, Jimmy.
Give me that knife. I taught you too well.
You just want that woman.
You couldn't be more wrong. I didn't pull you out of that workhouse because I took pity on you, Peter. I did it because of the debt I owed. To your mother.
You knew my mother.
I vowed to bring you up and rear you as my own. And I won't give up on you now.
This is how I want you.
It was your father's.
I hate to break up such a touching reunion, but we have to get out of here.
Give me another minute with him, Liz.
There is no time. The place is a tinderbox. It's even more beautiful than I remember.
No! No! I wouldn't tell your girlfriend the time of day.
I will give you one last chance to redeem yourself.
Stop!
Let him live, and I will tell you what you want to know.
What is that?
How to get into the tree spirit colony, and the secret of the mineral dust.
No, I have run!
And you do this just to keep him alive.
Only if you set him free.
Aya, run! Tire up! Come on, Aya! Run!
Peter! No! No! No!
There. I set him free.
Now let's get out of here.